you wrote a book called Seeing Through the World, Jean Gebser and Integral Consciousness, or Jean Gebser, as you said. So first off, I guess, before we get into the real bit of it, like what impact did this have on you personally? You know what I mean? Like what did this whole, you know, process have on you, you know, or specifically Jean Gebser, I guess? Because it seems like he's had a very big, you know, and very long influence on you.
Yeah, no, certainly.
So I mentioned, not to say that in a bad way, by the way.
No. It's good. That's good. I mean, so maybe more so than Wilbur, I think Gebser has been the most influential. Again, I really found Gebser through Ken Wilbur's work as a, you know, one of these foundational thinkers in integral theory. Mm-hmm. And at the same time, I was reading Teilhard in undergrad, I was also reading Jean Gebser's Ever-Present Origin for the first time. Mm-hmm. And really on the first page, you immediately notice that Gebser's doing something different. His writing style is different. He's very difficult to read, but he's working on you. And he seems to be communicating something about integral consciousness, or what integral, going integral, becoming integral is or means. It has to do more with aesthetics, phenomenology, time, the felt sense of being in time. Mm-hmm. So immediately there was just different work to be done to understand what Gebser is offering. And it was just kind of that was the lead for me, just sort of following that and sticking with it and really letting the book work on me over, you know, I don't know, since 2008 or 2009 or so.
Oh, wow. Wow.
And then I ended up getting involved in the Gebser Society in graduate school and doing some presentations, and I ended up getting involved with running it and eventually like creating the conferences myself and working with the other Gebserians. Mm-hmm. So I got just very involved there. And I think part of it is I've just found Gebser's work to be, I wouldn't exactly say unfinished, but it speaks so much to our time in that he was not a developmental thinker. He wasn't attempting to create a grand theory of everything. And so much of his work really converges with thinkers like Bruno Latour. I would even say Deleuze and Guattari. And even the folks on the left, like Mark Fisher or Bifo Berardi, just talking about temporics in our culture and the sort of exhaustion of a forward marching oriented future, just in terms of progress and modernity, that kind of cultural exhaustion of that attitude of the future means more progress, means more technology, means something better and greater, et cetera. That cultural attitude seems to be exhausted. And Gebser was talking about that back in the 1940s, which I found to be interesting. Wow. And then also talking about, you know, there's a lot of overlap with his thinking on, well, okay, what does it mean to, you know, in a similar way as Bergson talks about, to think with time. So a lot of his thinking is really foundationally about that. How do we think with time and allow time to shape and form our thinking and our perception? And then also, how do we overcome this civilizational crisis that we're in? And so all the things that he ended up talking about back in the 40s, cultural atomization, fragmentation of different people not being able to speak with one another, the sort of oscillation, as he says, between anxiety and delight around technological progress, all of that is really, it's the present, you know? So in many ways, Gebser writing this in 1949, 1950, 1951, seems to be speaking about our own time. And I found that to be interesting because Wilbur, as interesting as he is, as this grand synthetic thinker and meta picture thinker, some of what he talks about is a little dated. The theory itself, in terms of, you know, if you like meta theories, is very helpful, is interesting. But the substance, the philosophical substance of Gebser as a writer seems to speak more directly to our own felt sense of what's happening right now. So that's kind of the through line to introduce him a little bit. He was also just like a few.
No, go ahead. He was also what?
I was just going to say a few biographical notes. You know, he was, I think he was born in modern day Poland, but it was Germany at the time, or just the different geography, I suppose, of the different states in pre-war Europe. But the gist of it was he began as a kind of poet scholar, really a scholar of Rilke. And he was really interested in all of the different developments in the arts in earlier than the mid-century, really kind of the turn of the 20th century, between the Surrealists and Dada, and again, the sort of the creative developments in German poetry, particularly through Rilke, and how they were using grammar and language differently. And then, being a kind of generalist thinker, he ended up moving into, well, there's a new cultural attitude happening, and it's happening in the arts and in the sciences. Mm. And so that really became his life's work, is really articulating what this cultural shift was. And for him, he used the language of a consciousness shift or a consciousness structure to really talk about that. But part of that was also kind of discovering like an archaeology of consciousness, these other layers, these other orientations that have, we talked about a little bit, we just touched on the term, you know, pre-modern or traditional cultures. We could talk about indigenous cultures and their orientation with place-based thinking and temporics, et cetera. So Gebser sort of saw all of these other layers, and really his approach in terms of the ever-present origin is to kind of go, we're all of that. We're all of these different things. We're not just modern, in his words. We're not just in, he called it the perspectival world, sort of the structure of thinking since the Renaissance period, and really the kind of the arc of modernity. We're more than that. And actually that, as modernity in the perspectival world, is breaking down. And so there's a whole new orientation relationship with time, space, the subject, you know, the hyper-individualism of modernity is seems to be waning, and we're becoming something else. So that's like Gebser in a quick nutshell, but kind of, he opens it up to so much discourse presently on the non-human turn, the ecological turn, his discussion on perspectivity and objects kind of lends itself to object-oriented ontology. So that's where I'm at with Gebser at the moment, is this, there's so much he can be in dialogue with in terms of contemporary philosophy and maybe cultural studies.